Hello, no.
Hello, no.
Hello.
Well, we told you we wouldn't miss saying goodbye, didn't we?
Hello, baby. Are you all excited about your trip?
I'm getting excited. I talked to Daddy and Holly on the phone, and they said, we'll meet us at the airport.
Oh, such a long trip. You know you're going to sleep on the airplane.
They said they have beds and everything.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. You're going to have such a good time.
Oh, I wish I could go with you.
You can come. I know Daddy would just love to see you.
Oh, sweetheart, I would give anything in the world to see your Daddy, but maybe next trip, huh? I think you should be all alone with him this time, huh?
That's what Mommy says.
You can let it rain.
No, I can't.
Don't answer me.
I have to answer you, please.
Hello?
Yes, hello, Mommy.
Well, there's only one person in the whole wide world that calls me Mommy, and that's my Robin.
Oh, shucks, I gave it away.
How are you?
I'm just great, and how are you, Mommy?
Oh, I'm fine. And I'm all the better for talking to you.
We've been out a lot. We've been sailing, I've seen kangaroos, and oh, Mommy, how I'd love to have a koala bear.
I've missed you, sweetheart. It's so good to hear your voice.
I've missed you too, Mommy.
You're having a great time. That's the most important thing. And how's Daddy?
He's super.
Good. That's great.
How are all my godfathers and Uncle Duke?
Well, your godfathers are fine. And I'll tell you that you miss them. And Uncle Duke is really well. I'll tell him you asked for him.
Thank you. If I come back talking like an Australian, is that okay?
I'll take you any way I can get you.
I'm sure glad you're all right and everything. And I sure missed you. Maybe you can call me tomorrow, huh?
Yes. I'll call you tomorrow, darling. I miss you. And send my love to everybody there.
Okay. I love you, Mommy. Bye.
I have fun with
Daddy and Holly.
Oh,
I live in Australia, but I miss my home and my friends.
Well, we all missed you too, Robin.
Yes, it wasn't the same without you at all.
Hope you didn't get too lonely.
No, I managed to stay busy.
Towards the end of my vacation, I couldn't wait to get back here. Buzz, and I tried to tell Uncle Duke, and Frisco's away, and I couldn't call Sean. I had no one to talk to. Yes, you have to come to Port Charles right away, because somebody wants to kill Mommy. Yes, Mommy. Please, Daddy, you have to come to Port Charles. You have to come and help us.
Don't tell me kangaroos can fly.
No, they invented the aeroplane.
It's been too long. Man, how's Holly?
Listen, first things first.
Oh, that's... Hello.
Hi, Annie.
It's wonderful to see you. How's Holly?
Holly's fine. Good. Well, what are you doing here in Port Charles?
We'll get to that later. I'll get that.
And
we don't want any. As soon as you put your tongue back in your mouth, you can come in.
Wait a minute. Scorpio, Mike. Hey, listen, it's going to take me a little time to recover.
Good to see you, mate.
Good to see you. How long have you been in town? If you tell me it's more than a couple of hours, I'm going to take it personally.
Looking good, Chief. What's happened?
Well, I'm just fine. What about you? Did you get homesick? How's Holly?
Holly's fine.
Oh, good. I know. You got homesick for civilized territories.
Well, what do I have to do to get a cup of coffee around here?
Oh, Robert!
Hey, baby! Oh. Your trillion flash has arrived.
I should be furious with you, you scoundrel.
What, do I owe you money?
No, you've been in town for days and you haven't given me a call at all. I mean, if it weren't for me, you wouldn't even be in this city.
Tiffany, you haven't changed a bit since I saw you swinging through the jungle.
Oh, Robert, you look wonderful.
I've missed you. Holly's been trying to duplicate your chili, so far with less than successful results.
How is sweet Holly?
She's fine, sends her love to everyone.
Well, why didn't she come to visit?
Well, I wasn't sure how long I was going to be here, and somebody's got to look after things back in Australia.
Oh, I understand by the grapevine, my friend, that you have quite a spread down under.
We like it.
Oh, good.
You know, I was under the impression that you had a wife in Australia.
My background isn't in question here.
Oh, but mine is.
I want to know everything about the new man that might be invading my daughter's life.
Thanks again, Buzz. I love him so much.
Yeah, they're cute, aren't they?
They remind me of my daddy. When I miss him real bad, I get someone to take me to the zoo so I can see the koalas. You know they're from Australia.
Oh, I expect you must be quite an expert by now in the land down under.
It was the best vacation ever. Daddy and Holly took me out for a ride in the outback. We saw a whole bunch of koalas and kangaroos running around free.
You must have had a great time.
What?
Scorpio, what are you doing here? Project. This was supposed to be a private meeting.
I know, sir. I'm kind of surprised as you are.
I heard you were back in town.
Good to see you again, Robert.
You too, Steve. How's Audrey?
Fine. And Holly?
Dr. Hardy, if you don't mind, this is a strategy meeting.
Oh, dear. What did we ever do to deserve someone like that?
Hmm? Yeah. She's one of a kind. Do you know, it kind of tears me apart not to be around her full time. She's growing up so fast.
I know. But you didn't abandon her. She understands. Besides, you'd have to rule those wonderful godfathers. There aren't many absentee fathers that would do that.
I know she's in good hands. Sean and Frisco will always be there for her, look out for her. I mean, I didn't choose just anyone to be her godparents. But I know they'll always do what they can for her.
She might not have to rely on her godfathers for much longer. She'll have a new father of her own. A new stepfather. I asked Duke to come and join us later. That's right.
Don't expect me to change my mind about him. Until I'm sure that he's absolutely clean, I have no intention of allowing him to have any influence over Robin's life.
You already have his word.
Well, you've got to answer for that, haven't you?
Of course. I would gladly... He's a wonderful man. He's going to make a wonderful stepfather.
Not if I have anything to say about it. She's far too important to me to allow just anyone to step into my shoes.
She's important to me. Don't you think she is? I would never let anything happen to her.
You're blinded by love.
Oh, well, what's your excuse? What are you blinded by?
Caution. A step-parent plays a very critical role in a child's upbringing. You should have no doubts about that person's character.
I don't.
Be honest with yourself. We're talking about Robin's welfare here. Now, I have no doubts whatsoever about Holly as a step-parent. Can you say the same thing about Lavery? Oh, yeah.
You know, talking of friendships, I think Frisco would make a pretty good WSB agent.
Maybe.
What's going to happen to him if he doesn't square things with the force?
He always got back to singing.
That'd be a waste of an agent. You say we put in a good word with Valentine, huh?
What? Frisco and the WSB? No yeah. way.
Come on, Robert, why not?
Well, for starters, think of what the both of them have got together. The firm is no place, never was any place for love. The secrecy kills it. You know as well as I do. There is no such thing as a personal life for an agent.
Robert, you were thinking about what happened to you and Anna, right? You weren't unique. Others tried love. Training instilled in you a suspicion that just challenged everything good or evil. How does love survive against that?
Look, I know that was the toughest time of your life because you thought she betrayed you in the field.
When Anna left, a part of my life left too.
Well, at least you got a second chance.
Yeah, Holly. I am lucky. I did get a second chance.
It's because you're a good man.
What's that got to do with anything?
Who knows? Who knows?
Ramsey's on his way.
Diana should be told about what happened here tonight. You know how to get in touch with him?
No. I don't want Robert here either, so we're not going to call Philomena.
That's a good thing you got everyone out of the house.
Yeah. Robin would have gone to the door, opened it, seen the bomb, picked... Oh. I don't even want to think about it. All I want to do is get my hands around Grenville's neck.
If the guy has any brains, he covered his tracks, Robert.
Yeah? Well, no one's tracks are covered here. Not even Lavery's.
You really think he's mixed up with this group?
What's happened here tonight just makes me realize that I have no intention of allowing Robin to stay here with Anna.
What are you talking about?
If she chooses Lavery after tonight, I'm taking Robin back to Holly. Holly adores her.
Oh, so does Anna. Hey, she's not going to let you take Robin away from
her. I'm not offering multiple choices here, Sean.
Look, you've got one big fight in your hands, and I'm telling you that. Besides, the courts are always in favor of the mother.
Oh, yeah? I've got some good court evidence out in that street. It's a bomb crater. That's enough to convince anybody that Robin was right about that threat to Anna.
My life began again that night, too.
Are you free of Robert now?
No. I won't be free of him until he leaves Port Charles. Robin's such a link, you see.
How much longer do you think he'll be here? I thought he had a charming wife waiting for him in Australia.
Holly? Yeah, she's charming. I don't know. As soon as he finds out that there's no threat to Robin, then he'll go. You can't really blame him for that, can you?
No. No, I can't.
The person I wanted to see.
Ooh, why can't you just say just the person I wanted?
Those were the days, right?
Oh, they were, weren't they? Oh, I wish we could have him right now, back in the present, right this very moment.
Yeah, well, you never changed. Hmm?
Unfortunately, you did. I mean, what's this? I suppose you remain true blue to Holly, who's halfway away in the world in Australia. No, don't answer. I don't even want to hear it.
You still light up my life.
I'm glad I light up something, Robert. Thank you.
I need a favor.
Well, I need a scoop that you promised me. Remember, the only thing I'm going to get around here is Duke Lavery in his chains, if I'm lucky.
You'll get your scoop. I need the favor now.
Holly? Yeah, love. Yeah, I'm fine. I miss you too. Terribly. Robin's doing okay. Yeah, she's having a great holiday. I don't know when. Maybe Christmas. I'm not sure. Yeah, I know, darling. It's been too long. But you know I can't leave here until I make sure that Anna and Robin are safe. I will. I'll be home as soon as I can. I love you too. I'll call again soon.
Get hurt or killed. But I'm really... I'm glad about one thing anyway.
What's that?
Well, if anything happens to me, I know that Robin would have a good home with you and Holly.
Nothing's gonna go wrong.
All right, then. I'll send Robin off to Australia with Holly and Robert.
Do you think I'd let you...
That's what I'm going to do.
Such a sacrifice. No, Anna.
Robert! Robert, will you come in here, please?
What is it?
I want to speak to you. I want to tell you about this plan.
Don't listen to her, Robin.
Would you take Robin for a while in Australia with you and Holly?
I will not let you and Robin be separated, Anna.
Will you?
I can see what you're doing.
Good.
No, it isn't. The next few years are very important for Robin. She has to spend them with her mother.
Much as I want my daughter, I have to agree with Duke.
Besides, you've got your father here for Christmas. That's wonderful, isn't it?
Yes, isn't that great that Daddy gets to stay here for Christmas?
Mm-hmm. And now Holly arranged that, your Auntie Holly, so you ought to write her a thank you note.
I will.
Okay. There we go.
Yeah, Mr. Robert Scobbio live here.
He's speaking to him.
Oh, right.
Sign here, please.
Hang on a sec. There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh, Holly, my darling. This is getting to be a bad habit. Miss you. Love you. Holly.
Ooh.
Oh, my goodness.
Daddy!
Hey, where you guys been?
Oh, we've been marketing.
Yeah?
Yes,
for the feast Gran was going to make.
Yes, I better go and put this down in the kitchen. Excuse me.
I've got your present, Daddy, which you can't see until it's all wrapped.
No squeezing, no shaking, yeah. None of that.
No way, Jose.
Yeah.
No, not...
You know what?
What?
You are the best Christmas present of all for me.
Yeah. Well, I was going to call you tomorrow, sweetheart. Of course, I couldn't wait. I got your present a little while ago, yeah. I miss you so much, too. Well, you'll be with my uncle and friends. Yeah, something. Of course, I'm going to think of you all the time. What? Yeah. Yeah, I'm praying that things will be settled here pretty quick, too, so that I can come home. Of course I do. Merry Christmas. I love you. All right. Goodbye.
Right.
Oh, no.
Why do I get the feeling that's my present you're wrapping?
You'll have to go back to the living room so I can finish.
Oh, well, can't I come here and maybe have a cup of tea first and take in some of these wonderful aromas that Philomena here is preparing for us, huh? Come on, yes, yes, no, no. Hmm?
Okay, I guess you can breathe a little bit if you want.
Holly sends Christmas greetings to everybody.
Oh, wonderful.
I wish she could be here.
Well, maybe next year.
Don't go. Is that Holly? From Holly?
Well, it's sort of becoming a Christmas tradition.
I'm sorry that you're away from your wife this Christmas. I really am.
I spoke to her earlier. I have a very understanding wife.
Hmm. This must be stretching it a little bit.
She knows I wouldn't stay away unless I thought it was absolutely imperative.
Maybe you ought to... Maybe you ought to go back. The day after Christmas. I mean, you know, now Duke isn't turning state's evidence or anything. I think Robin and I are going to be very safe.
Well, what are your plans now that this case has been solved? Any other tough cases to crack in Port Charles?
Well, if there are, I'm sure that Chief Devane is more than capable of dealing with them. I'm going back to Australia.
You are? Well, when did you decide that?
Well, it was never my contention to stay this long. I mean, if you forget, I have a wife, remember?
Of course, he has a lovely wife, Holly, back in Australia. Well, she must be very proud of you. How do you think she feels being married to a hero?
I wish you'd cool up with the hero bit.
Hmm? I saw your interview on television with Tiffany.
Oh?
I didn't know you were going back to Australia so soon.
We didn't ask.
Oh, come on, that'd be funny. I'm sad, you're going.
Hey, I've got to go home sooner or later. Memory has it that I've got a wife back there. And she's been pretty patient.
She's been a saint, yeah.
Friendship?
Friends.
To us.
To us.
Hmm. Hmm.
Oh. Robert, I'm going to miss you so much.
Oh, darling, you'll get over it. You did last time.
Hmm? Yeah, I know I did, but you're not gone yet. I'm going to miss you so much. I can't stand it.
Well,
you know, Tiffany's right. Nice having you back. I won't be the same without you.
You really mean that?
I really mean that.
Well, that's why they invented airplanes. Come and visit me.
Well, we might just do that.
All right, it's an open invitation. The house is big enough and there's plenty of room.
Ooh, that means that Sean and I won't have to share guest quarters.
Only if he wants to. We get back to you on that one.
Choked on.
She's something else, all right. So what is it you want to show me?
She is something else. This, like this.
Oh my God! Uh-huh. The Robert Scorpio time capsule.
You left this stuff in my warehouse when you and Holly went to Australia. Robert Scorpio. This is your life.
What? What do we got here?
That's a deed of the diamond mine, and here is the map.
You know what? This thing here is the reason I was in Port Charles in the first place.
You owe it all to me, too.
Come again?
Oh, I was the one who invented that cover story for you. I even bought the mine.
In that case, I hereby bequeath it to you in lieu of your duty of giving the Quatermains back their ill-begotten stash.
Oh, how wonderful. You know, I am so touched that you would give me something that you consider absolutely worthless.
Come on, we paid absolutely nothing for it.
Hey, this thing has potential. Come on. It is surrounded by the Quatermain and Cassadine mines.
Well, anyone with that much optimism deserves it. It's yours.
Oh, good. I'll keep it. Who knows? I might end up rich again.
Good. In that case, you can come and visit. Done.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes, hold on a moment. Robert. Anna Devane.
Be right with you.
I'll say goodbye.
I want you to come and visit us.
I'd love to do that.
You said that last time.
I'll try. You take care.
You too, darling.
Miss you.
I don't care. I don't want him to go.
Come on, sweetheart. I'm very disappointed in your behavior this morning.
Daddy, if I'm not with you all the time and you don't stay here, then I'm going to starve myself to death. So there.
Oh, Robin.
There. That's better. Now, you want to talk about it?
I just don't want you to leave. Is that wrong?
Of course not. It's only natural.
you're going to feel a little bit sad. But, you know, I can't be with you always. And soon, well, soon you're going to be part of a whole new family.
Mommy and Uncle Duke.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, they both love you very, very much. And then, when you come to Australia, well, you'll be part of my family with Holly. So you see, in effect, you got the best of both worlds. You've got two families. Not too many little girls in the world have got that. Four people who love them very, very dearly.
It's a good job I'm here, or else Holly would think you hadn't seen an iron since you've been here.
I haven't.
Must have been hard, being without you for so long.
Well, Holly knows that whatever you and Robin are in trouble, and I'm on the next plane. That's part of the deal.
Everything's splendid, Robert. Yes. Oh, well, Duke's doing various things, trying to get back on his feet. But you know how that is, don't you? It's been hectic at headquarters, yes. I've been run off my feet. No, she hasn't left for school yet. She's still here. You want to speak to her? Okay. Thanks for calling, Robert. It's your father. And don't forget he's calling from Australia. It's very expensive.
Everything's fine?
Yes, everything's fine.
Hi, Daddy. How are you? That's good. And Holly? She did? Oh. Send her my love, too. Omi, I'm just...
Give it here. Hello. No, she's just upset. She misses you terribly. We weren't expecting your call, Robert. We're all fine. Yes. Send my love to Holly, too. Thanks for calling. Bye.
We can't send out the invitations now.
Because the date might change, I told you.
Yeah, that's right. We might get married sooner.
Sooner?
Mm-hmm.
It's possible.
Well, in the meanwhile, we can finish our guest list.
Absolutely.
Can I address the envelope?
Uh-huh.
I've been practicing. What's it called?
Calligraphy. Beautiful handwriting.
Why don't you say so?
That's a pretty fair question, actually.
Are Daddy and Holly coming?
They most certainly are invited.
Oh, good. The first thing I do is just a sample.
Just a sample?
Yes.
More tea.
You. Does Robert know you're getting married today?
Yes, he does. I wish there'd been time for him and Holly to get over here.
I'm sure he's very happy for you. I know he likes Duke a lot.
Yeah, he does. He is happy for me, too.
Actually, my nurse should be here about now.
So what?
Okay, I don't like playing games with you, so I'll tell you.
Mm-hmm.
A little earlier at the hospital, I got a call.
Oh, it's okay. I'll just get rid of them.
You do that.
Now.
Yes.
What happened to your purse?
Well, he probably put it in his mouth.
Just for that, I'm not going to tell you.
Good. Sit down. We'll do the luggage and everything.
Well, I can deal with the luggage.
I mean, you brought
what
it
What do you got in there?
Are you staying?
Well, maybe for the night.
Well, Robin, of course, Robin will have love it.
Oh, good.
Hey, look. If these ladies throw you out, you can always crash with me.
That's very big of you.
We won't throw you out. Why didn't you call?
Well, you know what I'm like with surprises.
Yeah, I know. But you called him.
Well, I had to find out if you were home.
Yeah, I was home. And now you're here. Well, I've got lots of questions.
Well, I'm still a little off balance as to everything that's happened to you.
I don't want to talk about me now. I don't want to talk about me. I want to talk about you.
No. Actually, she has some great plans for us.
So tell me about them.
I don't want to. Tell me about you and Holly and Australia and why you're here and why you brought all this luggage and how long you're staying.
Yeah, news.
How long am I staying? Well, this time round, it could be quite a stint.
Oh, Robin will be pleased.
Yeah, well, I have an assignment here.
Is Holly coming over?
What are we doing for coffee these days?
Well, it's in the jar.
Then some tea, perhaps. You know what
tea?
I like?
You want tea?
Yeah, in the kitchen. Go on, do. Off. Now. Off, go.
Well, don't talk about anything while I'm
it's
not here.
It's a deal.
No, just you.
I figure.
You're stalling.
What?
Something's wrong.
I'll be right there.
Something you don't want Anna to know about?
You always knew whether the news was good or bad before I even opened my trap.
I got a feeling this is a bad one.
Okay, kettle's on.
Huh? Do you have anything else? What's the matter?
I don't know you.
Robert? What's wrong?
Holly's dead. I got wind of the plane crash while I was in Washington, WSB channels.
An airplane crash?
In the outback.
Oh, Robert, I didn't hear anything about an Australian airline crash.
You weren't. It was a private plane. If I should have known, something was very, very wrong.
About the crash?
No. No, about Holly.
I don't understand.
Well, you see, at the airport... Just going to confuse you. She drove me to the airport. Now, this whole thing came up at the last minute. It was very hush-hush. I couldn't tell her anything. But she could tell that something was having a rather nasty effect on me. She was trying to say something to me. I put her off. She was having a rough go of it. I was off in the Twilight Zone somewhere. I guess I wasn't listening too closely, otherwise I'd have probably cottoned on to what she was leading up to.
Robert.
Huh?
Would it help if I ask a direct question?
Please.
Were you and Holly having problems?
Sean, I really don't want to get into this right now.
Okay,
fine. Right, fine. We'll talk about the plane crash then.
Holly had decided that maybe it wasn't a bad idea if we had a bit of space from one another. And this was all my fault.
She loved you, Robert.
Look, let's get back to the business at hand.
You're up to your ears in the WSB again.
And that's the reason I'm back here in Port Charles. I mean, it's only natural that I want to spend time with my daughter after all that's happened, isn't it?
You know, if there's one person who could handle her, it's Robert.
Well, thank you very much, but I wondered what he would do in my shoes.
Well, he's really happy with Holly, you know that. You and Anna, you make a great pair.
Well, you know, I'm in two minds as to whether he should even join the Bureau. I don't want him putting his marriage on rocks just because he wants to go gallivanting around playing some cloak and dagger games all over the place, you know? I mean, it's a kiss of death for a relationship.
Nobody should have to put up with that. I'm going to get a refill.
Mommy! Look who I found at the park! Mommy, did someone come to visit? Whose suitcases are those?
Mommy? You remember me?
Daddy! Oh, God!
Oh, sweetheart.
I didn't know that you were coming.
Well, it was sort of a spur-of-the-moment thing.
Who called you this time? Not me.
Welcome back, Robert.
G'day, mate. Good to see you. How you been?
I've been better. I'll run along home. I see you're having a family reunion. School books.
But you didn't get your present.
Some other time. Thank you. Bye.
So, how's Holly?
Look, why don't we go into the other room and have a little chat?
Aren't you denying that you sent for Robert?
I didn't send for him.
Oh, so he just appeared out of thin air, then?
He came for his own reasons, and they have nothing to do with us.
And what does his lovely wife think about this?
She's dead.
I'm sorry. I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
I just found out about him myself.
So... Robert's come here to spend time with you and Robin, is that it?
Well, I don't think there's much left for him in Australia.
Hi, sir.
I'm working my way around the world selling nuclear weapons. Can I interest you,
Robert,
in a car?
Hey, welcome home.
Oh, hello. It's good to be home, I tell you.
Home? Mm. I thought home was Australia.
Well, you two look good. That married life must be agreeing with you.
That's the only thing that does. Listen, I'd really like to talk to you if you get some time in the next day or so.
Sure, plenty of time.
So it brings you back to Port Charles?
Well, I was wondering how the place was getting along without me.
Well, how long are you staying?
Could be a while this time.
Did you bring Holly along?
No, Holly couldn't make it.
Well, that's too bad. We'd really like to see her.
Look, I think you should know something. A bit of a change in my life since I saw you last. Holly unfortunately died in a plane crash.
What?
Oh, sorry about that, Robert.
Yeah.
Hey, guys!
Returns. Got a sight for sore eyes.
Oh, good to see you guys. Hey, here's your tailor.
Well, the one that you left me.
So what's the action?
About that?
You got the usual.
No, he's dead.
Nothing's going to happen now.
What do you mean? It's your social life.
Robert's back in Port Charles. He's not married. Consider the possibilities.
That was yours.
We, didn't make a great couple, but as parents, I think we do very nicely.
Knowing she's here makes most of this bearable.
Especially now.
You know, when I found out about Holly, I had to come back. I knew that. I needed a security blanket. You two are it.
I wish there was something I could do to make you feel better. Can I ask you something? If it's personal or, you know, I'm out of line. You said that Holly had gone away on this plane for a while. Had you quarreled?
Every marriage has its ups and downs.
But you were in love. What happened?
It wasn't Holly's fault.
Well, it wasn't your fault.
If only I could have talked to her. You know, communication, that was always the strong point in our relationship. And in the end...
But you had a good marriage.
But do you suppose that she felt that maybe there was a part of me that she could never share?
Why would she feel that?
I don't know. I mean, I've never been with another woman. Not in a way that she might have thought. But I did.
You did come back here when Robin called you. Did that bother her?
I don't know. I never thought so. I always felt that she understood that part of my life.
She could have misinterpreted it, though. I mean, she could have felt you were making excuses why you came back here, or that I was still a very important part of your life. I wish I'd talked to her. You know, I wish I'd just told her that she was wrong, or that it wasn't like that.
I was very upset when I heard about Holly. I'm sorry.
I appreciate the sentiments.
Listen, old buddy, I hate to ask this question, but you think Holly's accident could have been an attempt by the DBX to eliminate you?
You think they were really after Robert?
It's a strong possibility. What do you think?
Frankly, this is something I never really wanted to consider. But if it turns out to be true, I think you know what I'm going to do to those people when I lay my hands on them.
We've been in and out of the bureau now for quite a while. We've had our crack at normal life.
You were never really out of it, actually. I mean, you were called back so many times, and now here you are on another assignment with a whole new future in the WSB. I mean, Holly couldn't have lived with that. There's no real blame there.
I know.
What are you thinking?
Well, I'm thinking that I'm now solo and I intend to stay that way.
I don't want to go to Italy. I want to stay here.
Darling, we've been through all this. What's the matter? What's this sudden change?
Well, what if something happens?
Nothing's going to happen. You'll be with Flamina.
Not me. To you.
Well, I'll be fine.
And I intend to make sure of that.
Yeah.
What about Holly? Look what happened to her.
Okay.
Maybe it's our working with the WSB that always dooms our relationships with women to failure, huh?
Could be that. I think it was that with...
Wait. Why don't we change the subject, huh?
Holly. I can say it.
I've loved two women in my life. The second, I lost through insensitivity. The first, I may be about to lose through stupidity.
What happened, Holly? It was different.
Anna.
You know, a lot's happened to me in the last few months. What with... with Holly. Everything else. I guess that just... being around you and Robin is... I'm not saying this very well.
What enough? You're too emotionally involved in all of this. You, Sean, and I are targets for the DVX at the moment. We should put everything else out of our mind and concentrate on the mission at hand. If we get through that, the rest of it will take care of itself.
I know you're right. I know you're right. It's just... let's forget it.
One more thing I want to know.
Look. There's nothing left to say. I've told you everything. I haven't held one thing back from you.
Did you try to kill me several months ago back in Australia?
Of course. And not only there, but Paris, Southampton, the Biscaynes, wherever you were. Not very successful, was I?
You thought I'd be on that plane with my wife. You were responsible for killing Holly, weren't you?
Sometimes innocent people die by mistake.
Did you kill my wife?
No.
Lena Parsons, I'm arresting you for murder, treason, and sabotage.
I would think you'd never paid a bill before.
Well, not if I could avoid it. It's writing out the check that I find painful.
So you have to expect these kind of expenses when you open your own business.
Oh, look at this phone bill here. Anna, did you make this call here?
Well, I don't know. One of us must have.
Yeah. Well... the phone company. Yeah, the phone company could have made a mistake.
Oh,
it's not above them, you know. Not in defense of the phone company.
No,
I won't hear.
As your first wife and your present partner, though it pains me to tell you this, when it concerns money, you are a total and utter complete failure.
Oh, that were Holly's words exactly.
Well, I mean, it's what most couples argue about.
No. Not us. Now, matter of fact, she thought it was quite funny. You know, I can remember this one particular time. It was getting close to the end of the month. We didn't have a bean between us. So we did the only practical thing possible. We got all the bills and heaped them together and we set fire to them. Then we bought a bottle of champagne with our last $10. Ah, yeah. She was very practical, too. She finally found a system. What she'd do, she would write out all the checks and just simply have me sign them. Now we were quite a team.
Okay, you were great.
Okay, sign the checks.
Right. You check these. Shouldn't they yours?
Any more bills? I'm going to contemplate suicide myself. Hey, look at this. Here's one from Australia.
Where's it from?
Well, there's a return address, but no name.
You didn't leave any unpaid bills out there, did you?
Well, none that could find me here.
We covered our tracks. Jolly good. Why don't you open it?
Yeah, why don't I open it?
Who's in charge here?
And what we have to do is clear up all this and get to work. And don't forget your letter.
Oh, yeah. You know, this address, it looks kind of familiar, but I'm not so sure about the handwriting.
Why don't you open it?
Yeah. Okay. Right.
I'm fortunate to find you both here.
Yeah. Get your letter.
What?
Who's it from?
It's from a cousin. Holly's in Australia. She said she went through some of Holly's things and found this envelope addressed to me.
What is she saying? What else?
I finally got the courage to go through Holly's things and found this envelope addressed to you. I hope you'll understand the delay and forgive me. I'm also sending along my favorite snapshot of Holly. You must have plenty of your own, but this is Holly as I remember her. I want you to have it.
Get this. I should be on my way back to you, my love. I simply had to go off for a bit to think things out. I know you wouldn't have left for Port Charles when you did, if Robin hadn't called and told you Anna was in danger. It was awfully selfish of me to complain about your being away so long. I realize now you wouldn't let me come with you because you were protecting me.
It's because it's been such a long time.
My beautiful Holly. My wife. My lover. I guess this is what marriage is supposed to be all about.
I love you so much.
Those weeks you were gone, darling, they seemed like years. Resentment is a nasty thing, but that's what I felt when you did get home. And, of course, that led to our misunderstanding, for which I'll be eternally sorry. What I need to do right now is get everything in perspective. I know I'll manage it. The reason I'm writing to you now before flying off is to tell you I love you, and I always shall. I'll be in your arms telling you all these things. Good night, my darling. We'll be together very soon. Love you. Love you. Holly.